Hey, so last night I was outside. My dog is out in the backyard running around barking like a maniac. And that's normal for our neighborhood. Everybody's got dogs. Everybody's dogs are out barking. So I go out to get him. And the next door neighbor's dog is barking on the left and on the right. My dog's over there scratching at the fence, trying to get my other neighbor's dog who's scratching at the fence, right in a fence fight, right? I'm like, yo, man, get over here. My neighbor pops his head over the fence. He's like, hey, Joe, just want to let you know, man, I'm going to be getting a new roof on my house tomorrow. I'm like, oh my gosh, is everything all right? I mean, was the roof leaking? What's going on? I mean, do you need some help? And he says, no. He says, actually, when we bought the house, we knew that we were going to have to replace the roof. So before things get bad, we're going to preemptive strike, right? We're going to have a preemptive strike and we're going to take care of this roof before it gets so bad that it starts to leak. And I was like, man, that's good planning on your part. And he's like, thanks, man. And I'm gonna throw my son under the bus here a little bit. My son has a car, and he comes pulling in a couple months ago, and this car is, as he hits the brakes, it goes, Wah! I'm like, oh, what in the world? He's like, yeah, something's wrong. I'm like, dude, your brakes, your rotors, everything. So he had to do it, and it cost him like hundreds of dollars to get it fixed. Something that maybe would have only cost maybe 150 was like $400, $500, $600 to get fixed. No preemptive strike, right? Before the thing went bad. And I started thinking about that in my life. How many times do I just ignore that squealing, crunching sound in my life? Whether it's in a relationship, it's in the way that I'm living my life, my attitude, the way I approach my job, the way that I approach my kids or my wife. Maybe it's your husband, maybe it's your neighbor, right? And we have these issues, and there's this loud crunching, squealing sound that's going like, yo, man, yo, wake up. Somebody says to you, like, hey, do you, man, are you angry? Are you upset about something? No, I'm fine. Woo-hoo. Right? No, you're not fine. I'm not fine when I behave that way. So as we go through these days, right, we need to be aware that our lives are in the same mode of the roof and the car, right? We have to have preemptive strikes on our life. When we start to see or feel or hear people tell us, hey, man, something's out of whack with you, we need to like jump on that. We need to go into scripture. We need to pray. We need to go to church and have interaction with other Christians and have the encouragement and support and love that they can pour out on us to give us wisdom on how that we should deal with these things. Because, see, here's the thing. If we go to God before things go bad, things may not go bad. May God continue to pour out his grace, mercy, and blessings on each and every one of us until we get to meet again. Amen. Amen.